Okay, hi everybody. It is July the 5th, 2016. Hope everybody in the USA had a great 4th of July with some fireworks and barbecues. Spend time with your family. Anyway, we're going to return to the Life is Strange playthrough. This says episode 3, but I should be on episode 4 now, no? I don't know. We'll see what happens when we click it. But okay, what happened at the end of the last episode, Chloe poured her heart out to me and said that she's just angry at the world and she blames her father for dying and ruining her life and the consequences of that. So I was in my dorm room looking at a photo of us from junior high, which actually found out later. It happened to be taken the day that her father died in the car accident on the way to pick her mother up from work. And so when I was staring at the photo, it started to shimmer, and I was actually able to, through my ever-evolving time powers, to go into the photo and alter the events of that time, junior high age, from five years ago. And I was able to prevent her father from ever driving that day, so subsequently he didn't die. And then when I came back to the present, I realized that things were different in my timeline now. I had actually, that change had altered a lot of things in life. And so I went to Chloe's house to see what was going on, and her dad answers the door. So amazing, her father William is alive. That's great, it worked. But Chloe comes to the door to see me, and she is in a wheelchair now. I'm not exactly sure yet, because I haven't actually talked to her. It was just the visual of seeing her, but it looked like her arms were strapped down to the chair, so I think she's a paraplegic. So this is rough. It's like, what is the greater good, right? Like, we have the girl in scenario one, where she's mad at the world and her life is shit, and her father is gone, but she's healthy. And then the second scenario is her family is well-to-do, her father is alive, but she's disabled. So what is the greater good outcome in that scenario? I don't know if I'm going to be able to change it and go back the way it was. I don't know, like, should I ask Chloe what she would want and let her make the decision? We'll find out. I don't know. Maybe it isn't even something I can change. I don't know. But it's such a hard call. It's like your loved one is with you, but you are yourself infirmed. Or your loved one is dead, but you're healthy. What would you do? I don't know what to pick. Hello, King Ian. How's it going? Go with the fro, bro. How's it going? All right, so we're going to, I don't know, what would you pick? What would you do in that scenario? What would you want if it was you? If it was you who lost your parent and it affected you so negatively, would you be willing to make that sacrifice of your physical well-being to have that parent with you? Or would you rather be healthy and, okay, I'm without my parent, I'm going to move on? I don't know, it's such a tough call here. So we're going to see what goes on. So we'll click it, and we're gonna click continue.
Previously on Life is Strange.
Whoa. You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with.
Don't ever touch me again, freak.
Turn that volume up a little bit.
Let's talk about your superpower.
What are you doing here, man?
I'm saving your life, Kate!
Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work.
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us. Miss Coffey, please, tell us everything.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right?
No spoilers, please.
We have to find Rachel soon. Like you said, it's time to start the search for clues.
This is my first playthrough. It's blind. I don't know any of this stuff, so I'd appreciate it if you keep it that way.
Come check out these files. Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it. Listen. I found pictures of Rachel and Frank. Being more than a friend. I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
So who do you most want to blame?
My fucking dad, of course. Hello?
No, you don't.
Do you know what it's like to wait for your father to come home when you're a kid? Ever since he died, my life has been dipped in shit.
Chloe, I am
okay,
awesome.
So,
we are awesome.
You can go fuck yourself with your spoilers here. I guess I'm gonna have to turn the chat off. I'm sorry that your life is so fucked up that you have to take the enjoyment out of things for other people, but I guess some people run that way.
Visitor.
Okay, so let's see what happens here. Choose wisely. Come on, I want to see Chloe. What's going on? Seaside beach stuff. All these dead whales came ashore. I was like, oh, it's a symbol. Two whales, two beach whales, but then wound up being three whales. I'm going to have to change the name of the diner to Three Whales. Or is that four? Might even be more than three whales. A lot of whales beaching themselves there. Episode 4, Dark Room. Okay, so we had seen something that it was like crazy scribbles that said, Rachel's in the dark room, Rachel's in the dark room, over and over again. So, I don't know. Maybe we're going to find Rachel this episode. I don't even know if there is Rachel. Like, everything is different. So many things have changed. I have no idea what's going on here now. Like, is there even a Rachel to look for? It just seemed like this was a straightforward, okay, Nancy Drew, I'm going to solve the mystery being Nosy Max. And now, everything is so different.
I'm glad we are, though.
So, I don't know what's going on now.
It's nice that you sent me actual letters. It's more than any of my other friends have done. And you even wrote on that cool parchment paper. It's so Max. So pretentious. But I love writing on it like an English poet. You deserve the best stationery. Probably easier to write than to visit me. I don't mean that in a bitchy way. Not totally. You probably wanted to avoid awkward conversations like this.
Pretty much. Yeah.
So, is she gonna tell her? Like,
I still want to laugh and talk shit with my best friend.
Yeah, I mean,
can we stop?
I think that with anybody who has a disability, that
seriously the best view of the city.
They don't want to be defined by it. They want to just be treated normal.
The golden hour.
See, without you here, I'd have no clue that you could take some amazing shots. Those beached whales are so sad.
Looks like 4 whales. 5 whales?
I don't know how they feel. At least, I'm alive here with you.
Kind of know how they feel. I can't move.
You're a real survivor, Chloe. I know you have to deal with so much. I don't want anybody else feeling sorry for me. I can do that. Along with my parents. My dad still feels guilty about buying me that car.
So it was the truck. Okay. Do you blame William, or do you want to talk about the accident? I'm gonna go with... Do you want to talk about the accident?
Are you okay to talk about the accident? We never actually have, huh? There's not much to say. Some prick in an SUV cut me off and I flew into a ditch. Do you remember everything? I saw everything in bullet time. I felt my back snap and... And that was the last thing I ever felt in my body.
Wow.
When I woke up in the hospital, I literally couldn't move a muscle.
Jesus. I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything. I'm just happy I did get to see you again. I could have ended up vanishing out of the blue like that girl from Blackwell.
Okay, so Rachel is still missing, I bet. And that's the other thing about people who are in this situation where they can't move their body and just move their head. Like, they have a shorter life expectancy because they wind up ultimately dying of generally an infection because they get bed sores and stuff because they can't move their body around. They sit in the same spots and it just gives them sores and they get infections and die. Like, that's what happened to Christopher Reeve after he had his horse accident and wound up like this. You mean Rachel or what missing girl? I'm gonna let her tell me because I don't know Rachel. I don't want to make it seem like I know Rachel. I don't know. It doesn't sound like she knows Rachel either. So let's see. What missing girl?
A missing girl. I don't know her name. I just read about it in the news. I feel bad for her family.
This is such a different world than when we were kids, isn't it?
After that snow and eclipse, it's more like the end of the world.
So the snow and the eclipse have still happened. It might be. Or don't say that. It might be.
It might be, but... I'd like to think we can still change things for the better.
I'd like to think that too. But I don't have much hope these days.
I know things seem out of control, but as long as we're together, I don't feel afraid.
Hanging out with you makes me feel like a total kid again. You don't even know.
Listen, Chloe, I'm sorry I haven't been out to see you more. That was wrong. You're my best friend.
Max, thanks for coming out to see me. You're doing awesome.
I don't think so.
My nose is getting cold. Maybe we should get back to my place?
It is hella cold out here.
Hella? I hate that word.
I hate that word. So different now. Because she was all about the hella before. And now she's not into the hella. Okay, so now she's still hopeless, but she just has a different kind of hopelessness. Now she's feeling hopeless because of her body, and before she was feeling hopeless about her entire life situation. So I haven't really made anything better for her. It's just different. Okay, what's gonna happen here? Like, am I going to confide in Chloe? What's going to happen? Maybe they're going to leave that up to me to decide.
It's a pretty high-tech lair.
Feels like a high-tech cell. But I am lucky my parents bust their ass to take care of me.
Wow.
I know it's hard for them.
They're grateful you're here with them. Right. Especially when they can't even take a walk alone. Sometimes I act like a total teenage brat just to give them an excuse to yell at me.
Haha.
Pathetic, I know. Chloe, you're a great daughter. You're kind and sensitive. When you don't even have to be. Trust me, I still get my rage on. Especially when a nurse has to watch while I take a dump so she can wipe my bum. Or when doctors flip me around like I was a science ball. I can't even imagine. But you're still amazing. You always have been since we were kids. Thanks again for coming, Max.
Max has got a heart of gold.
Need to get my drink on. Can you bring me some water?
Okay, am I going to be in control now? Okay. I didn't notice when she came up to the house that there was a ramp. But there would have had to be one. Okay, makeup. Well, here's the cup. I don't want to move events on, so I want to look around first.
Oh, man. She has to use that ventilator just to breathe. At least Chloe doesn't weigh that much.
So this lifter gets her in and out of the wheelchair? Into the bed? Yeah, she's total paraplegic. Okay, look out the window.
Does Chloe look at the garden and think about her childhood? She can't even feel the grass now. That's a serious heat lamp.
Keep her warm. Like, she can't even feel her extremities to know she's cold. She had to go by her nose to figure out that it was cold outside. Teddy bear! Teddy!
Hello, Chloe. She likes fluffy animals now.
Sorry, Chloe. Just looking at all your things.
The snow dough. I guess not everything changed.
There's one of the lighthouse, too.
Snow globes are taking over.
Okay, wheelchair.
I still can't believe I put Chloe in that chair.
Well, what are we gonna do?
Chloe's message board since the accident sure looks lonely. It's nice my parents sent a card at least.
Chloe, you know we love you and you're in our hearts and thoughts. We hope to see your smiling face soon. Please be well. Thinking of you.
I wonder who this is.
Megan.
Generic card.
Megan. Dear Chloe, I am so sorry for what happened. Know that I'm here for you. If you need anything, I hope you feel better, and I hope to see you again, Megan.
I wasn't very available to Chloe. Real nice.
Chloe, just thought I'd drop you a quick note to let you know I'm thinking about you. I feel so lame writing shit like I hope you are well, etc. I know your life is so different now, and I don't want that to get in the way of our friendship. Yes, I haven't been around lately, but that will change soon. I hope you are well. Love, Max.
At least I sent road trip selfies to Chloe. I'm sure that made her feel great.
Hot dog guy. I probably send her the hot dog guy plushie for a souvenir. Here's a hot dog guy plushie because you weren't able to come on the trip with me to see hot dog guy. Or is he a corn dog? I think he's a hot dog. What is this?
Yeah. Joyce and William built a whole new bathroom for Chloe.
Oh, they put an addition on the house so she has her own bathroom now. Did they? I'm assuming she's on the main floor now. Okay, I can't go out.
I should offer to put makeup on for Chloe. Not that I can, but it would be fun.
Okay. And what is this?
Whoa. Chloe can totally control her computer. It's so great people get this high-tech help.
It's kind of ironic that she wanted...
It's so cool that you're here again. I'm glad you think so.
That she wanted to steal money from the handicap fund, and now she herself is in turn handicapped. The irony is not lost upon me here.
That is so incredible. And she can browse cat videos on the web.
Yeah, that's what 99% of the internet is cat videos.
Chloe is still a punk at heart.
Black Attic Club.
She can't stage dive anymore.
So she still likes her punk
that's
music.
That's so cool that Chloe has made friends online.
Hot Wheels chat room. Miss Blue, so what are you doing? Talking to you, haha, no shit. I'm about to binge on Quantum Leap. Oh my god, I love Scott Bakula rules. So do you. I hope we can meet soon. Not if you're in San Francisco. Hey, I have to take care of some body work. Let me get back to you when you're binging. While you're binging on Bakula. You better. Hello? Okay. Handy bot. Got a few friends in this chat room. And what's this?
There's the old Chloe.
The punker bracelets. Alright. So now we're gonna get her water here.
Instead of handing Chloe a bong, I'm feeding her water. Did I give her a choice?
No, so maybe, I don't know. What is this drip thing?
That must be her mighty morphine machine.
Oh, she's on morphine?
No more bongs for her. I should have kept more in touch.
Okay, let's get her water. I didn't give her a choice, but I didn't know what was going to happen either. She would have said yes in the beginning.
Oh, man.
Not knowing the consequences.
No wonder my throat is dry. I don't think I've talked this much the whole year. Have you ever thought about doing a podcast or something?
I wish I could punch your face right now. A podcast? Dude, I am a pod in a cast. Boring. Ouch.
It was just a thought.
I know you're just trying to help.
Yeah, that's become a bad habit of mine. You sound like an adult now. Seems like we were kids in a room.
Helping all the time. Okay. What do you remember?
What do you remember about us as kids? We all have different memories.
I think about us as little pirates running.
Oh yeah, our clubhouse on the map.
Me too. But we're still pirates in our own way.
Yeah, right. Check me out, Chloe of the Caribbean. No way will I get on a fucking boat now. Unless you're with me. As you can see, I can't keep all my other friends away.
Hmm. You have me.
You have me. I'm not leaving you, Chloe.
Well, you didn't visit me a lot either. I mean, I loved your cards and photos, but...
I know I wasn't around much. No excuses, I'm a loser. But I am trying to make things right.
How? Dude, you're not Supermax. And I'm not trying to guilt trip you. That's what my parents are for.
Okay. Are you lonely? Are they okay and they love you? I'm gonna go with, are they okay?
Are they okay? I mean, are they still happy together and everything?
So now you're Dr. Bill? I guess they're good, considering they have to deal with me. They laugh and hold hands. And I hope they still get busy, too.
I think Joyce and William are incredible.
Max, the accident has been so hard on them.
Oh,
no.
So they still have money problems. Oh, my gosh. They just have different money problems now.
Can they pay all the bills?
No way. They keep the numbers away from me, but it doesn't take much research to find out I'm costing my parents almost $1 million a year.
Holy cow.
You're priceless. No pun intended.
You're such a geek.
So it seems like we still have the same problems, we just have different problems. A different kind of problems.
Practically a human entertainment system.
Same problems in a different way.
To chill out together and watch a movie like when you'd spend the night at my house.
What do you want to watch?
I think I'm in like a mellow Blade Runner mood. I always cry at the end.
Blade Runner, sweet.
Plus, you know, I always wanted to have cool colored bangs like Chris.
You would look incredible with blue hair. Well, let's get this show on the road. And you better not fall asleep on me like you always do when you watch movies.
I remember, Max. Swear I won't fall asleep. Not when you're here. Not yet.
Okay, so what else is... Where's the TV? We're gonna, okay. So now I get to see some other stuff I didn't see before, like in these drawers.
Oh my god. I made that mix for her when we were 12.
Pirate power! Okay, so the DVD's gotta be in here somewhere.
I want to see her as nosy as ever.
Yeah, that's me, Nosy Max.
I'm gonna disappoint you.
I'm Nosy Max.
Here's the DVD.
Blade Runner, bitches! What else? It's like, should I offer to do the makeup for her? I'll put the DVD in. Let's see. We should have watched Back to the Future, and then I could broach the subject of time travel with her and explain things. Is she falling asleep already? Fell asleep. Did she stay up the whole night or she just got up before me?
I cannot believe you fell asleep so fast.
I know you were beat down after the day with me, and Blade Runner is a pretty dreamy movie to watch at night. Do you think Deckard is a replicant? Sorry, I can see you're not wide awake like me.
No, I'm sorry I crashed so hard. Were you okay?
I do have a mother and father when you're not falling asleep on me. You are a bitch in the morning. It's the company I keep. Yesterday was such a blast. It was great seeing you. I know things were different when we were just dorky kids, but being with you made me feel like when we were little pirates jumping and running through the forests again. It meant a lot to me just to chill out with you and bullshit.
God, this has taken such a turn.
Fuck. I'm getting my regular head pains.
Is that what she's got the morphine for?
Please go upstairs and get my morphine injector in the bathroom.
Morphine injector?
It's total Star Trek shit. You can't even see the needle. Seriously, I need it. My parents keep this wag upstairs because they think I can't get to it. But you can, Max. Like a pirate, right?
Doesn't she have this drip thing here?
That must be her mighty morphine machine.
Is it empty?
No more bongs for her.
Oh, what's in here? I didn't get to see in these drawers before.
Nothing but medical supplies.
And here? I mean, I'm not gonna find any clues to anything.
She has to use a lot of lotion to keep her blood circulating.
Yeah. Yeah, because the blood pools, because she just sits in one place all day. More drawers here.
Wowzer. Chloe was a straight A student.
So opposite, huh?
She could have gone to any college. What a bastard. I totally should have let Chloe steal your bullshit fund. Even if it wasn't another reality.
As principal, I am in sympathy with your numerous requests for Chloe's special needs in regards to her wheelchair and class accessibility, etc. Blackwell prides itself on making sure students with disabilities receive full compliance under the Americans with Disabilities Act. However, given that the campus and buildings have all been constructed pre-1977, our school has not yet undergone the modern renovations necessary to fulfill all the needs of your daughter and her regrettable condition. Sadly, with recent deplorable federal cuts in education, it will take many more fundraisers to fully update Blackwell Academy, but that day will come. Chloe is without a doubt an amazing student with great potential despite her handicap, and I believe she would find a more fitting, rewarding scholastic environment at the H. West Miskatonic Institute in Bolton. They have a rich legacy of disabled graduates, and I know that Chloe would achieve her usual academic leadership in more comfortable surroundings. With her outstanding GPA, there is no doubt that Miskatonic would welcome Chloe with open halls. I hope you will seriously consider this suggestion, as I'm sure your daughter would prefer to attend a school that can cater to her many needs. In the same spirit, I've enclosed brochures for other potential schools in the Oregon region. If you have any questions, please contact my office. I'm not sure if that's legal. I would be interested to know if that's an actual loophole pre-1977. But that's why you see, like, in every public place that there are no doorknobs. They all have that hook latch that you grab. That's because of the Disability Act. Because there's some people who can't turn a doorknob. So you never see doorknobs anywhere in public areas. Okay, what else? One more drawer down here.
Even if you crashed on me. That's why they call it a sleepover. Despite everything, they're still a happy family again. It's cool that in this reality, Chloe really loves skating too.
Okay. I think we've seen everything here.
Does Chloe look at the garden and think about her childhood?
Okay, nothing different at this
time
of day.
She can't even feel the grass now.
Nothing different there this time of day. All right, I'm not so sure she's supposed to have this injector, but we'll go see what happens here.
They gave Chloe their giant expensive HDTV, and they use her shitty tube television.
So that's the opposite. Everything's different. Oh, Victoria's my BFF now, so she's texting me. Because in the other reality, the shitty TV was up in Chloe's room, and they had the flat screen here. Okay, what else?
Damn, this is just for Chloe's basic supplies.
Yeah, almost $9,000.
Bonjour. That's great they finally went to Paris.
Okay. Nothing on the answering machine. I missed that one answering machine.
These bills should all just say, "Dear sir, you are screwed."
Okay, what's this?
To think that our destiny is linked to goddamn car keys.
Yes, it is. I didn't go in the backyard last time. Let me go in the yard. That's where I wanted to put my graffiti mark, but there's somebody out here. Oh, there's Chloe's room. Okay. I thought I heard a voice.
Oh, man. The swing is gone now. It must have been sad for Chloe when William took it down.
Yeah, I didn't go out in the yard last time. I wonder if our old swing set was out here.
Chloe actually moved our drawing so she could see it from her room. Chloe.
That might have been in another area of the yard where you couldn't see it before.
I'm sorry, Bongo Kitty, but you passed on before I changed this reality.
What is that? What is that?
The house looks so great. William finally had the time to paint the house and fix up the garden.
I wonder if it was like in disrepair, notable disrepair before. More dead birds still.
Look at all these dead birds. It's happening here too.
Yeah, I remember seeing those through the window on the ground, but I didn't go out to investigate it. I wish I would have gone out now. Because I can only guess at what is different. Okay, so what else? We'll talk to the dad last before we go upstairs. Cutting coupons. Every choice penny counts. Coupon, boss. It's out of necessity. Nyam nyam sausage. That's my favorite. What is this? Cookies?
No change to spare anymore. Now it's back
oh,
to
yeah,
cookies.
Right. It was a jar that was holding the travel fund before, right? Okay. I guess that's about it. Wata. Ass-kicking robot leg, missing donuts. All right, so that's going to be it out here, right? Bongo the cat. Flyers.
Joyce and William never had a garage sale before.
Man, they're really pinching pennies here.
They're drowning in debt just to take care of their daughter. Such bullshit.
Your joint account has been closed and is now 6 months overdue. Please send check or money order for $3,500 to Happy Credit Card. Due to recent state and federal cuts, we regret to inform you that your health insurance no longer covers Chloe's physical rehab. Yeah, see, they need to do that just to move her body around. We can reinstate Chloe at a standard rate of $1,250 per week. Okay. Am I going to get the opportunity to go back the way it was? This is like It's a Wonderful Life gone... Well, I guess It's a Wonderful Life goes wrong, too. Newspaper.
These whales are just a preview of the tornado to come. And the Prescott Foundation? Jesus.
Half a dozen were dead or dying on the shore. The Prescott Foundation has vowed to provide extra research funds, given the local scope of
Rachel
this eco mystery.
Rachel Amber is even missing in this reality.
Okay, Blackwell Honor student Rachel Amber's not been seen for 6 months. Yet her family and friends have only intensified the search. Police and FBI have few leads and little information, which has caught the interest of the national reality show Where Did They Go? The Amber family has offered a reward for any information. Contact help at findrachelamber.org. Okay, what else? Let me go ahead and read these texts from Victoria. Worthless. Oh. I have a lot of texts here. Okay, let's start at the bottom. Dad. Okay, that's the same. Happy birthday. Victoria. All right, I gotta read all of these. Max, you busy girl, avoiding homework as usual. I told you I'd help you out. You'd never let me help. You never let me help. Okay. Okay, drama, stop. And you help me by caring. I do try. By the way, I scored that killer bud from you-know-who, FYI. Save me a bowl. I gotta bounce. Talk to you later. Come by my room tonight. Max, are we cool? I just wanted to make sure since you walked away so fast. Nathan was worried, too. If you want to talk, hit me up. Kay, love you. Max, if you're mad, just tell me, Kay. Silent. So if you want to talk, my door is open. Love you. Okay, this girl's like all over my jock now. She's like obsessed with me. It's like I'm the queen bee. Max, thanks for taking me to see my mom. I think she wants you for a daughter instead of me. I think not. Your mom is a badass like you. Yeah, right. I cried like a bitch. So did I. You just didn't see me. It's okay to cry. It gets old. My stupid phone is about to die, so call me back. So there's more to Taylor than meets the eye. Okay, Nathan. Yo, Max, you around in the dark room developing shots for the contest? Sweet. So no two whales for you. He wants to hang out with me at the diner. Not yet. I'll see you guys later, though. Peace out. Everybody's my friend now. Mom? Okay, happy birthday, that's the same. We need to talk about some of your bills. So I'm like I'm squandering my family's money. I'm spendy spend. I'm spending the money on drugs, Mom. You need to help me. I'm a druggie. Are you there? Yes, give me some time to answer. I can't just text in every class. Some teachers get super pissed when people use their phone. Yeah. Yes, because it's super rude, and please don't be so snippy. Sorry, long day of homework. So I'm a different person, too. You're not the only one, and that's why we're wondering if you... And that's why... What is this? Okay. Long day of homework. You're not the only one, and that's why we're wondering if you need to spend so much. We want you to have everything you need, but your scholarship doesn't cover everything. You said I could use your credit card when I needed it. I only bought film, not a camera. Maybe it's time to go digital. I'll call you later. I have to go. Don't pout. Love you. Hey, honey. Hope you didn't forget to water the plant we gave you, but don't drown it either. Okay, so she still wants me to keep Lisa the plant alive. And Chloe texted me? Oh, her dad. Oh, her dad gave me her number. Hello, Max. This is William. If you want to contact Chloe, you can use this number. She would love to hear from you. See you soon, I hope. Bye. Hey, Chloe. Maxine here. So I go by Maxine as well. I'm actually calling myself Maxine. Maxine here. I know it's been a while. I just wanted to let you know I'm going to Blackwell Academy now. I hope this is still your number. Wait, what is the date here? Okay. That's from March until the 8th. Hey, Pierce, thanks for the follow. Max is back. Blackwell, that is so awesome. You rule. Best of all, we can hang again. So, yes, this is still my number. Cool, got a buttload of homework, but we'll get together soon. Don't tease me. It's been too long. I know. I'll see you soon. And she did an emoji. Oh, my God, mind blown, because she would always give me shit for putting emojis, and now she's the one doing the emojis. So different. Okay. And Alyssa? Hey, Max, it's a shame that you hang out with those people. I thought you were different. Alyssa, I saw you throw that TP at me. Ha! So we did see somebody throw a roll of toilet paper before. Oh my God, I was not aiming at you, I swear. Don't do it again. So, I mean, no surprise there that it's Vortex Club throwing the toilet paper. All right, so let's look at what the dad is looking at.
They might get their own home taken away because of medical bills.
Oh my God.
That's terrible.
Dear Mr. Price, this letter is to notify you that you are in default of your payment obligations on your home loan. The current account holds the amount of $12,000 payable by August 1st. This amount has been overdue since March 1st, 2009. And you've ignored multiple requests to make a payment or reconsolidate your debt. Unless the full amount is received within 15 days, we must begin the foreclosure process on your home. We've given you more than adequate notice on this issue, and we have no other options left. Donald Clamp Lenders. So I'm assuming it has started already, because that was August. It's October now.
Hey, William. Am I bothering you?
Why, yes, Max. I love going through bills. Kidding. How can you bother me? I haven't seen you in forever.
I know. You look exactly the same. It's so cool.
Good. Or I'd be scared if I didn't look like me. Of course, you seem more adult now. So what's on your mind?
Oh... Paris trip. All right, let's start with Chloe.
I don't know how to say this, but I'm truly sorry about what happened to Chloe.
Me too. All it takes is a few minutes to change a girl's whole life. But she's alive. She's been a trooper.
Is she mad at me? I'm glad you're here.
She is amazing. I'm so glad you're here to help her and be her father.
I'm so glad Joyce is here to help us both. Max, I just hate to think of what would happen to Chloe if I wasn't here.
Oh my God.
I just want you to know that whatever happens, I'll always be here for Chloe. Always.
I know you will, Max.
Care room.
I was impressed by Chloe's room and all the high-tech equipment.
You should be. We could buy a few mansions for what it all costs. Insurance helps, but I don't know, Max.
I know it must be hard on you guys financially.
His bills are more like crushing. We have to mortgage our home, and that's pretty scary. But we'll get through it. The price is always right. Get it?
No? Bob Barker. Okay, we'll leave Paris trip for last.
Being around you and Joyce again is so nostalgic.
Very old school, as they say. I think it's great for Chloe to see you. Makes Joyce happy, too. So, it's not all bad news in Arcadia Bay. Or is it?
Crazy weather.
What do you think is going on with all of this crazy weather and animals dying?
Nobody knows, right? It is Nostradamus type shit, pardon my French. But all I actually care about now is Chloe and Joyce. My family.
Rachel Amber?
I was reading about that missing girl. Rachel Amber?
Oh, yes. She went to Blackwell, right? Oh, poor thing. That's a real nightmare for a family. I get scared thinking about Chloe and that we might lose her someday.
The Prescott family might be bad news. What do you think about them?
Evil. Next question?
Sounds like you know them well.
More than I want to. But Joyce has to work for those greedy bastards at Pan Estates.
Oh, she doesn't work at the diner anymore.
I don't want to think about it.
Pan Estates. Okay, Paris trip?
So you finally made it to Paris.
Oui, as they say. Not me, because I can't speak French. But it was a great experience, especially for Chloe.
I can see her loving it there. You guys rock for going on a family adventure like that.
She talked about going to school there, but that's not practical anymore. It's not fair, Max.
I have to go see if Chloe needs anything. It was so great talking with you again.
You act like it's the last time. And please, keep me from these bills whenever you want.
So, she kind of made up her mind that she wants to figure out how to reverse it again?
I definitely have to take a third job.
Okay. I don't think I missed anything else here. So we're going to go up and look for that injector. No garage stuff to do this time. Flyers mail. All right. I'm going up. So this was Chloe's room before, right? Yeah, there's nothing in here. They just moved her stuff downstairs. Butterfly!
I'm sure this is a total coincidence.
Or is it? Okay. Letter.
Too bad Joyce and William can't get any help from the Prescott Foundation.
Dear Joyce, thank you for keeping me updated on Chloe's condition. I can only imagine the struggle you and William are going through. I'm so sorry that I can't help you with a loan at this time. Like everybody else, I am underwater with my own medical bills. Please give Chloe a hug and my best wishes. Love, Aunt Dorothy. Crutches.
They bought crutches for Chloe, hoping she might walk again.
Optimistic. Toys. Oh my God, toys? She can't even play with toys.
I kind of want to open this and see what's in here.
Well, do I have that option?
Toys? I kind of want to open this and see what's in here. Shoes. Chloe always did love stomping around in her boots. I never heard much about William's brother.
Hi, Bill. Sorry for not staying in touch since the accident. Work has been piling up, and I'm being sent to Salt Lake City to oversee a new parking lot. You have to go where the work is these days. I wish I could have sent a bigger check, but you know the story. Money is nobody's favorite thing. Maybe I'll see you next spring for a visit. Kiss Chloe and Joyce for me. Hang in there, Billy. Your brother, Aaron. Inner monologue time?
I'm still overwhelmed by this new reality. And I feel so guilty for putting Chloe and her family through this. I could give Chloe the choice of keeping William alive, but that would be cruel. But then I see that they're a family again. You are the child.
How do you decide how somebody's life is worth more than another person's life? How do you make that decision?
And at least we never had to hide from Step Douche.
Huh. And here's, she scribbled all this out. This was our height chart.
I guess we stopped growing up together.
Oh yeah, right. No need to measure anymore once she's in a wheelchair, right? You can't stand up, you can't measure anymore. Oh. I don't know. Like, do I just put things back the way they were because otherwise I'm playing God?
Apparently the only thing that hasn't changed is this view.
Just help Chloe deal with her original reality.
So nice to have you around.
Oh shit, sorry. Just barging in. Hi.
That is such a sweet shot of Chloe. I wonder who took the picture. Look at them. They have no idea what's in their future.
Oh, this is the same photo. So this is when she's pregnant with Chloe in San Francisco. It was early in the game when I saw that. I didn't figure that out last time. With Chloe in parentheses. She's the baby bump.
Oh, no. I didn't realize how bad Chloe's injury really was.
So she dying? As we discussed last week, Chloe's respiratory system is showing signs of rapid weakening. This accounts for her recent anemia and loss of breath. As a doctor, I'm committed to her well-being, but I want you to understand the reality that respiratory failure is common in people with severe spinal injuries. Your daughter is one of the bravest, strongest patients I've ever had, and I'm proud to be working with her. I just want you as parents to prepare for any and all possibility. I believe Chloe should also be made aware of her changing condition. If you would like to discuss this further, you have my contact information. Man, the weight of this. And if I go back, do I tell Chloe that I did it? Do I tell Chloe that I did it and then I made the decision to go back? Ashtray?
Joyce used to hate smokers in the diner.
Stress smoking. Nosy Max, don't mind me. I'm just going to go through your drawer here. Hope you don't have any adult items. Supermom, Lead the Family by Dr. Bill. Okay. Let's go ahead and talk to her now and see what her point of view is on it all.
You and Chloe are so much quieter now than when you were kids.
I remember. It's nice waking up in your house again.
Oh, William and I love it. Finally seeing you and Chloe together after all these years. After the accident.
Chloe?
I wish I was a better friend. I know Chloe doesn't get many visitors.
Oh, Max. You're Chloe's best friend for a reason. You're here exactly when she needs you.
I hope so.
I hope so. You guys do such an amazing job taking care of her.
We can only do so much, and she gets damn sick of her parents. That's why it's so important you came to spend time with her. Max, Chloe's condition is not improving. Her respiratory system is very weak, and she... Do you know what I'm saying?
Joyce. I'm so sorry you have to go through all this.
Bad or good, I embrace every moment with my daughter and my husband. This is what it means to be a family, and we'll always be one, no matter what.
I have to tell you how much I love seeing you and William together.
The grief of losing your husband or the grief of losing your daughter.
Through all this, Chloe and I are lucky to have him.
Yeah, is William still the same? I think that's pretty evident. So I'm going to go with Chloe
and
William.
Chloe and William seem like they still get along so good.
Yeah, those two are closer now more than ever. Chloe will actually listen to William while she usually ignores me. Oh, it's so cute when they gang up on poor old me.
You rule, Joyce.
Things would be different if I did. I like how you think, kid.
How are you doing, Joyce?
I'm doing the best I can, Max. I won't lie, it's difficult, but nobody said life was easy here in Arcadia Bay.
David Madsen? She's gonna be like, who? Oh, I wonder, do I have the power to rewind? Okay, let's go with Eco Havoc.
So,
I'm assuming I can still rewind. I haven't tested it, but...
Eco Havoc.
Maybe Arcadia Bay just wants to be left alone. I know the feeling. Honestly, I don't give a shit about too much outside our house.
I don't blame you, Joyce.
Except now we have dead birds and beach whales outside our front door. So maybe I should care, for Chloe's sake.
A lot of work.
Plus, you guys have to work, too.
Oh, Bill and I have no time for ourselves. We're working more than we're living. I even had to take a part-time gig at Pan Estates. Ugh.
Do you know the Prescotts?
I know that Sean Prescott won't be happy until he owns everything in Arcadia Bay. Stay away from his son, Nathan.
He's my buddy in this new reality. Okay, David Madsen.
Do you know somebody named David Madsen?
Nope.
He, might hang out at the Two Whales.
Well, that was random. Yeah, he's a bus driver.
Yeah, that was random.
He comes in sometimes. Cute, quiet. Why?
Oh,
Because he's your husband!
Curious.
What?
You always were. Nice to see that everything doesn't change.
I better get back to Chloe now. It's good talking with you, Joyce.
You too, honey.
Okay, seeing everything. Right? Or did I get in this drawer?
Neat and tidy as they used to be.
William is trying so hard. He's still awesome.
They both have Dr. Phil books. Okay. So that's it in here, right? I mean, there's nothing major going to be found here. They're just going to realize how dire their situation is financially and the hardship of caring for a disabled person is, right? That's, I'm getting the hammer over the head on that one. Which one was the bathroom? This open one here. Lights on, please.
How's it going, Time Tripper? Funny. I think I look older.
Do I dress older? Do I have makeup on? Like, more makeup than I did in the other reality? That might be true. I might have more makeup on. Okay, let's see. There's two sides to this cabinet. Search.
The bathroom looks almost the same. Just more medicine.
And this one.
Here it is. I never thought I'd be delivering morphine to my best friend.
Yeah, no doubt.
Nothing here.
There was some pill bottles there.
It's cool that Chloe uses natural medicine too.
Okay, so I got what I'm after. Morphine injector, so I'm gonna have to do it. I can rewind. Okay, I was wondering that.
It's all about you, Arcadia Bay, isn't it?
Okay, down we go. Don't mind me, William. I'm just going to give your daughter some morphine. No big deal. I'm sure you're totally cool with this. Like, if I talk to him, you know, there's no option to discuss it, right?
I definitely have to take a third chance.
Yeah, he's just in same repetition mode here now. I got the morphine, Chloe. Morphine.
Finally. Give me the blue pill.
Blue pill.
I'm sorry. I'm nosy, but not precise. Go ahead and plug it right in. It's so easy. And painless.
It's so easy to inject morphine.
You need to yell for your folks if I screw up. Oh, trust me. I will.
Shouldn't I get one of them to help me with this? I don't even know what I'm doing.
Of course, my pain just keeps getting worse. But you caught me on a good day. Max, I'm so grateful that I'm even able to hang out with you. See, I'm getting mushy. I'm already high. You're so adorable. Do you want anything else? Stop me if I'm being too emo, but can you grab one of the photo albums over there? I'd like to check out some old pictures of us when we were kids. Please. My diary is like emo ground zero.
I love the dialogue in this.
Not pass up a photo op with Chloe Price. Ever.
So I can take a photo with her now? Let me look at this thing.
That must be her mighty morphine machine.
Okay, yeah.
No more bongs for her.
Photo album. I don't have my camera. I don't have a bag. I can't even take pictures anymore. I'm like so different. How do I not have my phone, my camera?
Is that okay?
I wonder if I even use the Polaroid anymore, if I'm so different. Because I told my mom I bought film, but it doesn't mean it was Polaroid.
I remember that day by the lighthouse.
My dad was pissed at us. He actually tried to give us a timeout.
And you laughed at him. My dad would have banished me.
Turn the page.
Beep. Whoa, awesome picture. We look so badass in our pirate gear.
We should have taken over Arcadia Bay when we had the chance.
There's still time for you. Oh man, there we are making pancakes. I love that shot of us. Hard to believe my dad took that picture only 5 years ago.
Oh, that's the photo.
It seems like yesterday.
That's the photo, right?
I wish it was.
Can I
focus
on the photo and...
This photo.
Yeah, I could go back now.
Maybe I could...
Listen, Max. My respiratory system is failing and it's only getting worse. I've heard the doctors talking about it when they thought I was zonked out. So I know I'm just putting off the inevitable while my parents suffer along, and I will too. This isn't how I want things to end.
What? What are you saying?
I'm saying that being with you again has been so special. I just wanted to feel like when we were kids running around Arcadia Bay and everything was possible, and you made me feel that way today. I want this time with you to be my last memory. Do you understand?
Yes, I do.
All you have to do is crank up the IV to 11.
Oh my god. What? Can I get the photo?
Chloe, I really don't know if I can do this. I had another friend who wanted to end it all, and I did everything I could to try and save her life. How can I be responsible for ending yours? I mean, there's gotta be another way. Max, you were there for your friend, no matter what. Now I'm asking you to help me the same way. I want to help you, Chloe, but I think my help is hurting. At least you have a choice. When you want to make a decision, you can just do it. Look at me.
She just wants to die with some dignity on her own terms.
For once, I want to make my own choice. The most important one of my life. Please.
Can I just use the photo? What if I make one of these decisions and then it won't, my rewind power fritzes out again and I can't go back on it? So if I... okay, I'm gonna refuse.
Can't.
Obviously, she doesn't feel like...
It wrecks me to see you in any pain. And
is that legal in Oregon? Can I go to jail? Is that a right to die thing? Plus, you probably need to, like, write it out for me.
And William, I already said my goodbyes to them, but they won't honor my wishes. You will. Right? I can't kill you with an overdose.
Like, am I just supposed to say it was an accident?
My illness, not my dosage. This accelerates the process. I'd rather go out on a wave than a rock. And I want my best friend to help me out. I am going to help you, but not like that. You have to believe me, Chloe. Why, Max? You're just bailing on me like everybody else. Why don't you go now? You've been wanting to since you got here, right? So go and don't come back. I am never leaving you again.
Get the fucking photo. Can you get the photo, please? Can I get the photo, please?
I'm sorry, William.
Come on. There we go.
Someday Dad'll get one of them newfangled computers.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper. Hello? Hey, honey. What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar.
You mean your college fund?
Is she gonna throw it in the fire so that I can't even be tempted to do it again? Oh, I can't go back now. That's it.
Dad. Don't blow it, because tonight your mother promised to make us a world famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert.
She took away the option to change her mind again. It's a final decision, burning the photo. It's such a weighty thing deciding, playing God, who lives, who dies, but...
Max, you are being so fucking strange. Like, you're never gonna see us again.
Chloe, I'm so sorry. I tried to make things different for you. I did try. I'm sorry.
I don't know exactly what you're talking about, but come on. You have made things different, like, my whole life. You're my best friend. I've got you and a great family. What's to be sorry for? We'll be best friends forever. And when we grow up, we're taking over the world.
Listen, whatever happens, I want you to be strong. Even if you feel like I wasn't there for you. Because I will never abandon you, Chloe. I'll always have your back. Always.
Stated the timeline. So everything's back the way it was now, so... Back on the case. So where is this art? Don't remember seeing it before. Is this in her room? And there is no photo.
Chloe, you're back. Oh yeah, now you suddenly want to kiss me?
I'm so glad you're here.
You sound high. But thanks for the morning grope. Since we were up all night playing CSI Arcadia Bay, I was still spaced out here trying to put all this info together. Max, did you forget we've gone over this? I hope you weren't messing around with time while I was sleeping.
Not anymore. Yeah. I'm just spaced out too.
Just a little bit.
Welcome back to the real world, Max.
Wow. Oh my gosh.
I don't think I can ever.
Yeah, I mean, if you told her and then tell her you went back and killed her dad all over again, she's going to be so pissed. And then if she says she doesn't care and she wants you to do it again, you can't because you burned the photo. It doesn't exist anymore. Like I said, I think... since she played God and did it the first time, the right thing to do was to go back the way it was and not let Chloe live like that. Okay, I'm gonna stop this here just for the sake of breaking the videos up into about hour long parts. I don't want it to go longer than that. So I'm gonna stop it here and then resume. Wow. Wow, what a great episode. Okay, be right back.